me was the whole aesthetics of the game. I was not ready for it. I had not watched the trailer. I knew nothing about it. I always tell the story of how I started playing it because it's very embarrassing. I was there was this cosplayer that I really liked, and I wanted to like just do a cosplay with her. And she posted this picture of her as Chloe on Facebook, and I was like, "Oh my God, I love this game. Let's totally do it together." And I had no idea what the game was, but I just wanted to do something with her. So that day, I got the game and I played it, and I was like, this is the best sense I've ever made, because I was just lucky there. And yeah, I started playing the game, and I had already played some of the Telltale games that are kind of the same kind of graphic adventure. And when I played this one, the way that things were, the animations, the lightning, the way that everything was designed was different from anything that I had ever seen in any video game. The music, the whole atmosphere was very like nostalgic, you know, that they had like all of these, the Polaroid pictures and the printed pictures and the cassettes. It was like all of the things from our childhood there, and in a very hipster kind of way, but I
Makes
was
sense.
kind of a hipster, so I didn't mind. And then that was like my first impression that I really liked. And then the second one would be, okay, I'm gonna name three things: aesthetics, the mechanics of rewinding time. I haven't seen anything like it in any other game. I feel like that's so interesting. Sometimes it doesn't even affect that much for you to go back and change your choices. But the fact that you get to hear what they say and it makes you question yourself again and you want to go back again and try the other way, and you're like, no, let's go back and do it the first way again. That kind of thing, I feel like it's awesome for these types of games that are based on making you feel like that, like so insecure about your choices.
Yes, they got inspired, I
And
think, by Butterfly Effect movie, and somehow they
yes.
managed to apply it to their game, and it was good. I agree with you.
Yes, absolutely. Yes. And the third one would be the characters. Again, it's, I feel, games with good characters and good stories are my jam. So that's why I like these, the ones in particular that we're talking
For
about.
example, this game is the one that we need diversity, and this is nice. You see, that's what I'm talking about. So here, for example, we have different races also, and this is very nice. So I
Yes.
hope that they consider this for their project. Okay, the third one.
The characters, that was like, so I said aesthetics, the time mechanics, time rewinding mechanics, and then the characters.
I see. Yes, I agree with you. Also, character developments, both in Witcher and Life is Strange, both of them, they worked on them and it was
Yes.
good. Exactly. And the
Very good
conversations.
character arcs for sure.
Yeah, they gave time to come up with those conversations, the details, everything was well managed as I understood. And what, how do
Yes.
you like the, how did you like the options that the game gave you?
I think when we talk about options, everybody always goes to think of the ending of the game. And I'm not gonna get there yet. I did like that they had lots of random choices, like the one where you get to choose what you want for breakfast when somebody asks you, like you want waffles or eggs and bacon or something like that. And I felt like those things made it feel like made you relax, like, oh, I can make this choice, you know, it's just breakfast. And then they're, you know, they throw you the very heavy choices at you that, you know, I'm gonna assume that people who are here have played the game and already know about the choices. I don't want to give away too much, but when I played it, I was not so, how should I say it? I was surprised that they actually gave us that choice at the end of the game. Because when I played it feeling like I had watched an anime before that had sort of a similar story, and I kind of saw where this was going, I was like, this girl keeps dying over and over. Like, this, there's no way that she, you know, she's gonna live in the end. So by the end of this game, she has to die. Like, that was what I thought. And then when we get to that part and they actually give you the choice, I was like, well, it's obvious, right? She had to die. Because honestly, the first time, this was the first time I played it, I didn't even like her. I didn't like that character. I didn't care that much for her. And I was not going to sacrifice all the other people for her. And I remember, like, struggling understanding people who were rooting for her and who liked her. I was like, I don't get it. Like, why would you kill all these other people for them? And then I played Detroit. And when I got to the end of Detroit, there's a choice where you have to choose between, like, saving, like, what are you going to put first? The whole revolution and everything that you've been fighting for and everything, or this guy? And I was like, well, of course, this guy. I love him. Like, he's pretty much our dad, you know? I was always rooting. And then I felt like such a hypocrite, because then I understood what it was like, and that my problem was that I never got to bond with the other characters. So I feel like it's important, depending on what your feelings are for these characters, what the choices are going to feel like for you. And I would say that's also a praise for the game. Like, they made it feel like, you know, it's all on you, and whatever you feel about it might be completely different from what other players feel. It's not a straightforward, like, I don't think anybody who plays Detroit will be like, yeah, no, let's crush the androids, you know?
Yes, exactly. And what about your dislike about Life is Strange?
Okay, here I can say some things.
Me too.
because I love, 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 love this game. But like I said, for some reason, and maybe I don't know, maybe this is not a bad thing about the game, but the first time I played it, I just didn't like Chloe. I disliked her so bad. And maybe that says more about me than the game, because when I played it again and when I played Before the Storm, I started feeling very different about her and I started disliking Max a lot. But I don't know, there were some character choices that were a bit inconsistent, maybe, sometimes.
For example?
I think it was mostly because I started getting involved with the fandom at a pretty early stage. And I realized, for example, from the beginning, that for some reason everybody hated Warren. And Warren was one of my favorite characters. So when I saw the hate online, I was like, why are these people on? And I remember, for example, that there was an animation where when you are watering a plant, you see him like looking, trying to see if Max is awake already or something. And everybody was like, oh, he's such a perv. And then the developers were like, nah, that's not what we meant. Let's scrap that. And then they got rid of it on an update. You know, looking back on it now, maybe because there's been some years, you know, and I've changed as a person, I feel like, you know, maybe he was not that great of a character as I thought back then. And again, maybe this is more of a personal thing. For me, with this game, it's just hard not to talk about that, about like, my feelings with it. And maybe that's why I call it not the best game, but my favorite game, because I get so emotional, emotionally involved with them. But again, you know, with, for example, with Nathan, he's another character that's very, you know, they're trying to make you like him, but at the same, like, in some ways, they're trying to make you like him, like, when he, but, oh gosh, I feel like every time I speak, I'm like, should I be spoiling this?
I think that's fine, because for Nathan...
Oh, I lost the sound.
Is it okay now?
Can you hear me?
Yes, I hear you very well.
Oh, but I can't. Why I can't?
Oh.
Let's see. Can you talk again?
Yes, is it better now?
Okay. Yes, yes, now I'm good. Now I'm good. It was my headphones.
Okay, so yes, I agree with you. It's actually not as hard as Witcher to say dislikes about Life is Strange. Of course, it was a good video game. I like the story, I like the characters, but as you mentioned, yes, there are some parts that you may don't like about this character, some of the characters. And also, I noticed that it doesn't belong to all ages, for example. For Witcher, age, either you're a boy or girl, you will love it. But for Life is Strange, I noticed maybe teenage girls love this game more than others. Would you agree?
Definitely, yes. Because they, you know, they can, of course, relate more. Like sometimes if some people, like I would recommend The Witcher to a way like wider group of people than Life is Strange. I always hesitate before recommending it. But at
and you
the
were
same
saying
time,
something about Nathan, by the way, I interrupted you.
Ah, yes. I was going to say, so I feel like sometimes the game is pushing you towards liking characters, even though, I don't know, maybe this is just something that I think maybe they're just trying to make you feel like they, not everybody, you know, bad guys are not like just monsters, you know, since we're talking about that, but they are just people who made bad choices. But at the same time, I feel like some things I remember just feeling very put off by the way that his character was developed at certain points of the game. And thinking of the mechanics, most people, I think they complain about how, again, about the choices, how they don't mean much in the end. But at the same time, when I watch some people, because I've watched like several different people play the whole game, and I realized that their games were way different than the way that I play. So I feel like even the small choices that you make in dialogues make you feel different things for different characters. Like maybe some people I saw, they interacted more with some characters than others, and they didn't get to know them. And I was like, no, but this guy, he was like so cool, and you didn't talk to them. And that's like in the choice of the player. I think the people who complain about their choices not paying off are people who are more used to other games, either like Detroit or those that are based around the choices and not so much in a linear story.
Yes, that's true. And what about the other games related to Life is Strange? Have you played all of them or just Life is Strange 1?
I played Life is Strange 1 and I played Before the Storm. I started playing Life is Strange 2 last year, and then I had to stop at a certain point, and then I never got back to it. I really, really want to, but it's just been taking me forever to just sit down and do it. I really liked Before the Storm. I was scared because I thought without the time thing, it was going to be like, I think you just have to keep your expectations there. Like, it's not going to be Life is Strange. You know, it's just going to be a little bit more of it, but it's not going to be the same. And the fact that we got to know Rachel, for me, was everything, because she was my favorite character in Life is Strange. And, you know, how when you play Life is Strange, you know nothing about her, but it feels like everybody knows something about her, and you just want to know more all the time. And just getting to meet her felt so exciting.
Sorry, just it, like, one moment, like I fix the camera. So you keep going, I listen to you, but just one moment.
Okay. Yeah, she just felt like a very exciting person, even from Life is Strange, when she was just like very mysterious and flawed, but everybody liked her. Everybody thought she was pretty cool, but we didn't know really what had been going on, because they said, oh, she was sleeping with this person, but she was also partying with these other people, but she also hang out with the other people who don't party, and you're like, how does everybody like her? What's so special about her? You really want to get to know this person.
Yes, exactly. And you know more about Chloe after meeting Rachel.
Yeah, I hated Max so much when I played that game. Like, I played Life is Strange, I was like, oh, Chloe, she's just such a drag. And then I played Before the Storm, I was like, well, yeah, I get you. Max was not good either. You know?
But you
maybe
know,
that was the point, you know?
Yeah, but
like
when
I said,
I
like
played,
everybody makes choices.
yeah, but when I played Before the Storm, I was disappointed because I was expecting something even better than Life is a Strange. So you already know this one wouldn't be as good
Yeah.
as that one. So I got a
That's the
little
thing.
disappointed.
That's you have to go with like lower expectations for me.
Exactly. But for example, it was also too relaxing for me. It was not thrilling anymore.
I guess, yeah, because you know, Life is Strange is very, it feels very life or death the whole time, and it's got all these supernatural elements. It's very, they have a very different feel. I think I went into Before the Storm just expecting to have like a very chill teenage coming of age story, and that's what I got, so I was satisfied with it.
So as a straight person, also, I wanted to ask you, didn't you find this game too gay for you?
So when I played Life is Strange, I didn't see it gay at all. I was like, I don't understand how people are shipping them. They're just good friends. Like, I'm like that with my friends. Like, I've kissed my friends. We've all, like, done silly things just
Oh,
because,
Rachel
like, we like to...
would be more than friends, of course.
Well, the first time I played, I felt that way. Because in my game, I was just shipping Max and Warren, and I didn't care much about Chloe. And then I found out that there was an ending where they would actually kiss. I was like, oh, I missed something. And then I watched other people play it, and I saw that some little interactions between them were different if you had done things to bring them closer together. And I was like a bit surprised, but it took me a while to see it. But when I played Before the Storm, I was shipping Rachel and Chloe so hard. Like, I think even from when I play Life is Strange, that's the thing. Like, I saw it as, no, Chloe was definitely in love with Rachel, but I didn't feel like Max and Chloe were a thing. Like, for me, they weren't such a good match.
Yes, you're right. I agree with you. Rachel and Chloe, definitely, they were a match, and we could see why they are best friends. But with Max,
yeah.
Totally different character.
Yeah. I wasn't feeling it.
And
Like,
I mentioned about that thing because also in Life is Strange 2, now we see the relation between two brothers. But all the time we see from the same gender. We don't see that much a love story between a man and woman in this series. So doesn't that concern you somehow to say, okay, why they are focused mostly on that? Shouldn't be more... I don't know, options maybe in this game. It's okay to be there as an option, but why not more also options there?
Again, I feel like it's in the way you play it. The first time I played it, I guess I wasn't, maybe back then I wasn't that used to seeing these kind of storylines in video games, so I wasn't seeing it at all. Like, for me, they were really just two girls who were friends. I didn't see it until people started talking about it, and I was like, oh, I need to go back and look at this again.
Yes,
but
all boys
for me,
saw the other versions, I think.
Maybe, right?
Yeah.
But because I think that because I had many female friendships that were kind of like that. But I think that's a wonderful thing. Like, for me, it's not concerning at all. I feel like, how many other games do you see where they focus on those kinds of relationships? This year, I played another game by the same company. It's called Tell Me Why. And the two, I don't know if you've heard of it, but the two main characters are twin siblings. And one of them is a trans man. And I think it's the first time they ever have a main character in a video game be a trans person. And I was like, I'm already playing this just because this is already interesting. And like, I feel
so
like this
what
should
was
be
the
done
name
more
of the
often.
game again?
Tell Me Why.
Tell Me Why. Okay, it's on
If you
PC.
like, they're very small. It's about the story of the two siblings and things that have happened. Oh, something happened.
Yeah, now it's okay.
Okay. So again, it's more about the story of the two siblings and things that happened to them in their past. But it's amazing. I loved every second of that game. And I super recommend it to you if you haven't played it.
Great. So I will play that. So who knows, maybe someday we will talk about tell me why.
Next July.
Next July. Yeah. And what about Life is Strange True Colors? It's new and it will be released September. So what do you think about that? Have you seen the trailer?
Yes, I'm so excited about it. Oh, I feel like Life is Strange too. I was kind of excited about it, but at the same time, maybe there was too much going on in my life at that time. But now that I'm again playing more video games again and everything, and I saw the trailer for it and I got so excited. I think it looks so interesting. I love the idea of this girl just empathizing so hard that she feels everybody's emotions and that she can sort of manipulate them or something. Oh,
Yes, it's
yeah, I
related to
just read
emotion.
Thomas said, oh, this is true. Tell Me Why Thank You is free right now because of the Pride Month. So you can get it on Steam for free, the
Oh,
whole
I see.
game.
That's good news. Thanks,
Thank you so
Thomas.
much for reminding me of that. But yes, I'm very excited. I really like that they brought back Steph, a character from Before the Storm that I really liked. Like just from watching a minute of the trailer, I was like, yeah, I'm shipping them.
Yes,
Because
we are waiting.
there's not that many games where I get to ship two female characters together. So if I get a chance to do it, I will.
I see, but what do you think about the main character now? Because for the previous ones, we could see some, I don't know, right away you were interested to see this character. But now we are
Yes.
more interested to see her superpowers. Because he looks pretty much ordinary, we could say, ordinary looking. She's even
Actually,
overweight.
the way she looks was I don't know if you've seen on Facebook that they announced it with just putting like a black and white or something shape. And I was like, she has hips. They drew her with a different body type than any video game character usually has. I'm playing this game like with something so silly that I'm like, why don't people think of this more often? You know, that already drew me to her. I know that doesn't say much about her as a character, but it says something about the people who made it and what they were thinking. And yeah, I don't know much about her, and I didn't even want to see much of the trailers. I saw like little bits of it just to get a general idea of what it's going to be like because I like just going into the game and getting to know her there. But yeah, it does look pretty interesting.
Yes, in that view, it would be nice that, as you mentioned, this is something new. We don't usually see one ordinary person become the hero of
Yes.
the game. But on the
Right?
other hand, when you play a game, you want the character to be attractive somehow, so that you keep looking at somehow fool yourself so that you see all the story. But sometimes when the story is so powerful, then it doesn't really matter if the person is not that much attractive. So, do you think they are so much confident about their story that they try
Yeah.
this maybe?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. And I'm confident in them. And I feel like it's a good way for people to widen their idea of, like you said, what attractive means. For us, attractive means what we're used to seeing. We're used to seeing girls who are kind of skinny, with curves, with this kind of hair, this kind of
But you
physical,
are
with this
saying
kind of
that if they
places.
keep showing these characters, then you may change your perception about attraction.
I think that people may get used to the idea that these people with different body types or different kind of faces will also be main characters.
Thomas says that I like her because she wears headphones.
I like you too.
I think also he's talking about the main character of Life is Strange.
Ah,
Superpower.
yeah, it's true. It's true. She's got a very, that's the other thing. She's got a very cool style. Like, if you look at the way she dresses, you're already like, oh, she's pretty cool.
Yeah, her style is good. I
And
agree.
I feel that it's important for people to feel like it's not only the really, you know, like either skinny or very attractive people, as we were saying, who are going to be the heroes, but any kind of, like you said, ordinary people may, you know, it's not so much about the way they look, but about what her story is going to be like. And yeah, I do feel like they're going to do. My expectations are high on this one.
So, do you think is it a chance that this one would be better than the first Life is Strange?
That's really hard because I feel like the first game was one of those games that just broke a lot of rules and did something that many other games had not done. And I usually, it's very hard for a sequel to be as groundbreaking as the first game. But I do feel, I didn't feel this way about Life is Strange 2. I just felt like, yeah, it's going to be sort of more of the same, you know? And I think that's kind of what it was, because there was not much noise about it online. Like, people liked it, but, you know, it was like, it was not as big of a deal. Whereas with this one, I feel like this game may bring a lot more things to the table than the second one.
Yeah, for me, her superpower was very interesting when I understood this is related to emotion. So maybe they are taking this to another level, and I'm excited to see how they pull it off.
Yeah. I really trust them with their choices. Like I said, this other game that I played by the same company this year is not made by all the same people, but when you play it, it does feel like a Life is Strange game. You know, it has the kind of the same kind of music and vibe and storytelling and the dialogues and the choices. It feels very Life is Strange-y. And it felt so good. I enjoy that game. It's now one of my favorite games too. So, like, I'm very confident in their abilities to create good stories.
I see. Selene, thanks a lot for joining me today. It was wonderful talking with you about these two interesting video games. Would you like to add something?
I would like to thank you. It's always very interesting to chat with you. Yeah, I cannot. If it was up to me, we'd just talk all night. But I know we do have to end.
The same here. I really enjoy talking with you. And who knows, hopefully next month we will come up with another game and we will talk about that.